this session, let's discuss about DC transient in RC circuit. For that, let's consider an RC series circuit excited by a DC voltage source V. At t is equal to 0, this switch is getting closed. Under that condition, current I of t will flow through the circuit. Assume for simplicity, initial capacitor voltage is 0. This is the time domain circuit. This we need to convert into S domain in order to make analysis in similar way. So V become V by S. R, there is no change. The impedance form of capacitor in S domain is 1 by Cs. And this current I of t become I of S. So this is the equivalent circuit in S domain corresponding to this time domain circuit. Now we need to apply KVL over this loop. So applying KVL, we can obtain this voltage equation, that is V by S minus I of S into R minus I of S into 1 by Cs is equal to 0. Taking I of S outside from these two terms, this equation becomes I of S into R plus 1 by Cs is equal to V by S. Therefore, I of S is equal to V by S into RCS plus 1 by Cs. These two S get cancelled. So further simplifying, V divided by, here RC we can take it outside. So V divided by RC into S plus 1 by RC divided by C. This C and C get cancelled. And the final expression for I of S can be obtained as V by R divided by S plus 1 by RC. Now, there is no need of partial fraction expansion. You can directly find out L inverse of this equation in order to obtain I of T. So, after taking L inverse of this equation, we can obtain I of T as V by R into E raised to minus 1 by C into T. In RC circuit, the time constant tau is equal to R into C. So considering that concept, in this equation, we can obtain current through that circuit or current through the capacitor as V by R into E raised to minus T by tau for T greater than 0. Now let's see the variation of current through the circuit and voltage across R and C with respect to time. As this circuit is series, current through resistor is equal to current through capacitor. And we got the expression for current as V by R into E raised to minus T by tau. So at T is equal to 0, this term become 1. Therefore, corresponding IR become V by R. And when we are substituting T is equal to tau, this E raised to minus 1 is coming. E raised to minus 1 is 0.3678. Therefore, IR become 0.3678 V by R. When we are substituting infinity, this term becomes 0. Now let's see the variation of voltage across resistor VR, which is equal to IR into R. Cancelling R, we got this expression, that is V into E raised to minus T by tau. Substituting T is equal to 0, we can obtain V. Substituting tau, we can obtain V into E raised to minus 1, that is 0.3678 V. And corresponding to T is equal to infinity, VR is 0. Now, we need to find out the voltage across this capacitor VC. For that, let's consider this equivalent circuit corresponding to T greater than 0. When we are applying KVL over here, we can write V is equal to VR plus VC, where VR is the voltage across the resistor, VC is the voltage across the capacitor. So from this, we can find the VC as V minus VR. Substituting VR as V into E raised to minus T by tau, we can obtain VC is equal to V into 1 minus E raised to minus T by tau, where tau is equal to time constant of the circuit, which is equal to RC. So when we are substituting T is equal to 0 in this equation, VC can be obtained as 0. And corresponding to tau, its value is 0.632 V. And corresponding to infinity, its value is obtained as V. Now let's plot these values into graph. First of all, let's plot this current. At t is equal to 0, what is the value? V by R. So this is the first point. At t is equal to tau, the value is reduced to 0.3678 V by R. And at t is equal to infinity, its value is 0. So from this graph, it is clear that current through this circuit is exponentially decaying. And finally, that current is die out. Now let's plot the voltage across resistor and voltage across the capacitor. First of all, let's see the variation of voltage across the resistor. At t is equal to 0, the voltage is V. And at t is equal to tau, the voltage is reduced to 0.3678 times the initial value of the voltage V. So this is the corresponding point. And at t is equal to infinity, its value is decaying to 0 or reaching to 0. So this black one indicates the characteristic curve for voltage across the resistor corresponding to this situation. Just like current curve, it is exponentially decaying. And finally, this voltage across the resistor die out. Then let's see voltage across the capacitor on this same curve. At t is equal to 0, its value is 0. At t is equal to tau, its value is increasing to 0.632 times the final value of the voltage V. And at t is equal to infinity, the value is reaching to V. So when we are adding these two voltages at any time, that is voltage across capacitor and voltage across the resistor at any instant of time, we can see Vr plus Vc is equal to V. That is clear from this curve. So from these curves, it is clear that corresponding to time constant, here the current decays to 0.3678 times the initial current. In this capacitor voltage, corresponding to tau, the voltage across the capacitor increases to 0.632 times the final value, that is the steady state value. So in both ways, we can define the time constant in this circuit. So we can define the time constant as the time required to rise the capacitor voltage to 63.2% of its final value.